Hi there, Tim from Checkly here. Today I want to talk to you about the performance and reliability of your modern web app. More specifically, I want to show you how you can use a new generation of headless browsers to catch common performance and reliability issues all before you go live in production. If this sounds a lot like end-to-end testing, then you're right. But end-to-end testing is a little bit boring and used to be flaky, right? Well, kind of used to be. But stick with me, and I will show you why I honestly think that we are entering a golden age of end-to-end testing. What's important to notice is that performance and reliability are top of mind among JavaScript devs. In the recent Jamstack Community Survey of 2021, performance, and in this case, uptime, were the number one and number two concerns for devs when building a website. This talk is going to be very practical. I will talk you through some code examples that you can run yourself using Node.js, Playwright, my headless browser framework of choice, and GitHub Actions. All of this code is available on GitHub in the link below. Essentially, I'm going to show you how to build a mini Checkly, because at Checkly, we run millions of these headless sessions per month. So no need to sign up to any servers right now, okay, except GitHub, to get your feet wet and start exploring. Of course, at the end, I will do an obvious pitch of how great Checkly works in this context and how it deeply integrates with Vercel for all your Next.js projects. Let's dive in. Here I have a very basic Next.js project using Next.js 11. This should be bread and butter to the most of you. Now, we wouldn't want this super enterprise-level website to be shipped to production with catastrophic bugs or terrible performance, would we? No, we wouldn't. So let's introduce Playwright to make sure that this doesn't happen. So what is Playwright? Playwright is an open-source framework developed by Microsoft that enables you to talk to a browser from your code. You can click on buttons, fill inputs, take screenshots, and much, much more. Playwright itself is written in TypeScript, so it plays very well with the JavaScript ecosystem. However, it also supports Python, Java, and .NET. What sets Playwright apart from other similar frameworks like Puppeteer and Selenium are its speed and its smart features like auto-waiting for screen elements to appear before clicking on them. Okay, let's write our first Playwright script. Here it is. It's a simple JavaScript file that I put into the end-to-end test directory, just step one. And this is my whole Next.js code base for the project I just showed you. So let's run through it and see what it does. Well, firstly, we install Playwright. In this case, I'm installing Playwright Chromium just for demo purposes, because it only downloads the Chrome browser instead of Chrome, WebKit, and Safari, as Playwright supports all of these three browser platforms. Then we have a small run function, an async function, so we can run the await code. We create a browser, we create a page. And then we set a target URL variable. You will see that it uses a target URL environment variable and a hard-coded production domain name. And I will show you why that is and how it comes in very handy later when we run this in GitHub Actions. So we go to our target URL with the page go to method. We click on our button. We snap a screenshot. And then we close the browser. That's it. So let's run it. It did the thing. It opened our target URL, in this case, localhost. Click the button, snap the screenshot, close the browser. Let's have a look at the screenshot. Amazing, it worked. Now let's get some more data from the Playwright script and create a little report on reliability. Okay, here's a rundown. I added a report object here with a bunch of counters that will record some key metrics that happen throughout our browser sessions. We have properties for all requests that finish with a good status code, so anything up to 399. Then we have all the requests above 399, the bad ones that fail. Then we have a failed request counter. This is just for request that error out on the network level and never respond. And then we have a counter for console errors. This could be anything, your own JavaScript erroring out, some third-party library, or some malformed JSON response confusing your code. And we collect this data by listening to events emitted by the Playwright page instance. You can see that right here. We have some listeners on request failed, on respond, and on console. And every time we do a little console log and we bump these counters. So all the way in the end, we just log this to our console, which you can see right here. And that's our little reliability report. Let's give it a spin. Oh my God, we have some errors. We got console error lines. You can see that right here, two of them. And we got a failing request also. And we have 11 normal requests that failed with a status code lower than 399. And what you can see that apparently we had some requests to some servers with a non-existing domain name. What's interesting also is that none of these errors were actually obvious when we snapped that first screenshot. So in this specific case, the image was at the bottom of the viewport and it was missing, and you can see that right here. So there is a broken image. Okay, let's add some performance metrics. In our case, I want to add some web vitals. Again, we create a data structure to capture these. And we're going to capture the web vitals FCP, or first contentful paint, and LCP, the largest contentful paint. We use a Playwright feature where we can directly inject a script into the page. And in this case, we're injecting the standard web vitals library that I just installed using npm. Note that we're only interested here in web vitals that make sense in a lab or synthetic environment, opposed to the web vitals collected in the field using real user traffic. For instance, what Vercel gives you with their analytics feature. So you can see a bunch of code here that essentially calls the library that I just injected and then adds the metrics to this little object. Again, we console log that object at the end of our script. Let's give it a run. Here we go. So we got the same errors, of course, as the previous run, but you can see that we added the first contentful paint and the largest contentful paint, and we logged it to our console. So how do I run my end-to-end script on each deploy? Well, there are many services offering this. Hint, 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 we actually do that, but you can run this from your continuous integration setup. We will use GitHub Actions for this. As you can see this file, I added it to the standard .github/workflows directory, and it's pretty standard actually. Let's walk through it. It targets, first of all, the Node.js runtime, and it checks out our code, it does a little setup, then it installs our dependencies, and then it runs the end-to-end test command from your package JSON. But there's three things to note here. Firstly, we only trigger this action when GitHub receives a deployment status event from Vercel in this case. Then we check if that deployment status is actually successful. Lastly, we assign a target URL parameter that comes with the deployment event and assign it to a standard environment variable so we can read it in our script. You already saw that when I ran our tests against my local host. In this case, we're going to get the preview deployment and the production deployment URL given to us by Vercel injected into the script so we can run our end-to-end test against all the preview and production deployments. So what does that look like in practice? Well, of course, I ran a little bit earlier and you can see it right here. This is our script and here is the test step. You can see what happens. We get a target URL that is specific for this commit. It runs through our checks and it prints the same info that we saw earlier. In this case, The GitHub action passes. We could add a little exit code to the script to make sure it fails, send you an email, or otherwise trigger something in your PR review to know, like, hey, this thing broke, I need to take action. What I just showed you is, of course, just the tip of the iceberg. Playwright allows you to script and test much more complex multi-step flows and extract a lot more data. And we do this at Checkly to check our own web app. Here's what that looks like on the Checkly dashboard. This is a multi-step Playwright script that logs into Checkly and navigates some key pages. We run these tests against our staging and production environment on each Git push that Vercel deploys for us, so not against a mocked environment that runs inside some CI pipeline. This gives us way more confidence that what we ship actually works in real life. What's even cooler, we also run the exact same set of scripts every 10 minutes against production. Two things to note here. All the Playwright instrumentation and collection of metrics is done for you automatically. We also automatically snap a screenshot for you when an error occurs in your Playwright script. And second, we now have a great integration with Vercel that can automatically block your deploys if any of these tests fail. If you want to play around with this, sign up for a free forever plan over at checklyhq.com. So let's take a step back. I mentioned at the start that I think we live in the golden age of end-to-end testing. What do I mean by that? Well, I mean that there's a convergence of three things. First, accurate preview deploys on each commit by companies like Vercel, Netlify, and others. Second, cheap, fast, serverless, Docker-based, or other ephemeral infrastructure resources. Third, of course, this new generation of snappy and easy-to-use headless browsers. Together, they make shipping reliable and performant web apps a ton easier and cheaper than it used to be. That's it for me right now. I hope I gave you some cool insights. As mentioned, this is just the tip of the iceberg. Visit playwright.dev for a ton more info on Playwright and checklyhq.com/learn/headless for an extensive set of guides on how to use Playwright in the wild. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.